And everything I do, I give thanks to God, whether it's in sports or outside of sports. So I would say that anytime I'm successful on the court, or I give thanks to him, or even if things aren't going good, I thank him for the little things like still being healthy. I'd say it's helped me because I know in the Bible there's a lot of times where Christians were persecuted and they responded in the best way they possibly could by still preaching. So I'd say in terms of sports, even if things aren't going good, you just keep your head in the game and keep going. I'd say just go out there and be a leader. I know in any sport it can get heated and people may start saying things that they shouldn't. And the best thing I can do is just lead by example. Whether it's helping my teammates if they're getting into it with another person, or even just, even if they're not, just still leading by example and keeping them calm. I would say just to maybe start out like baby steps. Maybe start out by praying every night or going to church. And then as you start to do that and learn more, start to incorporate the things that he would want you to do into your life every day. And then just as you do that more and more often, you'll kind of see better things happen along the road, and just keep your faith in him and good things will happen. It's way more than just being, you know, trained at these workouts. It's more so, you know, about helping others, keeping your relationship with Christ really strong. You know, after every workout we do, we check up with certain questions, and I think that's really important, and a lot of us can skip that in our daily lives, but I think the more we do that, the less stress we'll be. So I think taking time for ourselves is really important, and at the same time, connecting Christ with sports is really important, which we do here too.